The government of Uganda has found new market for its milk in Zambia to boost export. The Uganda-Zambia milk market route was yesterday launched by Agriculture Minister Frank Tumwebaze at Pali Dairies in Mbarari City. 50,000 tons of powdered milk were flagged off to Zambia. Here's more.
In January last year, Kenya, which was a large trading partner, banned milk from Uganda on grounds that the quality and standard was lacking. This led to a drastic drop in prices. A liter of milk dropped as low as 300 shillings from 900 shillings. Agriculture Minister Frank Tumwebaze says the new market in Zambia will enhance the development of the milk value chain in Uganda.
Thank them for opening up that new market opportunity. The trickle-down effect is to the farmer, and it contributes more and more development to our milk value chain. I congratulate them. I thank them. I have inspected their factory. It is state of the art. They are using the highest technology from Germany, Tetra Pak. They have different lines of production. They produce powdered milk. They produce yogurt. They produce UHT.
Tumwebaze invited those who think that Ugandan milk is of poor quality to come into the country and test it for themselves. He urged livestock farmers and agriculturalists to practice good post-harvest handling if they want to maintain the quality of harvests.
He or she must mind about the seed, producing production activities involved, the storage, both primary and secondary, the transportation, and the standards the market requires. When you hear people saying our Irish potatoes are not being bought by the processors, there must be a reason we need to know.
Make sure that you work hard also to support these factories that are buying your products. Another thing, don't over-demand for prices when actually prices are also determined by demand and supply. Then another thing, what I want the government to help farmers is to make sure that it improves on the quality of drugs for cows, such that these farmers don't make losses.
Baska Kotecha, the founder and chairman of Pearl Dairies, recalls that at the time Kenya banned Ugandan milk, they had expanded production to a point where the factory was taking in about 800,000 liters of milk every day from farmers.
We started exporting to Kenya. Now, Kenya is the biggest market in East Africa for milk consumption. But that also started growing, and because of that, we had to increase our capacity. Farmers have also started producing more. So this has kept on growing for the Kenyan market. And suddenly Kenya banned our products to go to Kenya. And we had to look for different markets. So we went to Tanzania. And suddenly Tanzania also, for whatever reason, they put a duty which is very, very high for the Ugandan products.
He said it was hard finding market in other East African countries due to heavy taxes.
It was Uganda, Kenya, Tanzania, Rwanda, Burundi. Those are the only markets that we are targeting. But unfortunately, all these markets are not accessible. Kenya, for whatever reason, they're doing it. Uganda has put a very heavy duty on our products. South Sudan is sometimes safe to go, sometimes not go. So it's not a very steady market. Rwanda, the border is closed. Because of that, we cannot access even Burundi.
Yosia Bagabo, one of the livestock farmers, said milk prices are yet to stabilize.
Katobwa hati, ebe yamate yachiriyari rukumi, kiku manyoba, basha zireo konka, ayinu kugambire shahe, baru dayari, yade tukurasili rukumi, abirneita, no, rukumi chikumi abirneita, nani ndeva tuchiriyari beye, kurne gumiza, kabe tutaru.
Pearl Dairies confirmed that they have the capacity to satisfy the market in Zambia. They buy 800,000 liters every day from about 10,000 livestock farmers in the region. Story compiled by Adolf Ayoreka for the news.